click start and then type graphics settings. And then once you type that, you should see the graphics settings option. And so click that, and this will take you directly to the graphics settings menu. Another way you can open this menu is by clicking start and then typing display. Once you type that, you should see the option to change display settings. So click that and then scroll to the bottom and click on graphics settings. Once you are in the graphics settings menu, you will see two options, classic app and universal app. Universal apps are those that come from the Windows Store, and they are universal because they are compatible with both mobile and desktop devices. And if you choose it, you will see a list of all of the universal apps on your PC. And classic apps are the conventional Windows applications with .exe file extensions. Now, if you choose it and click browse, you're going to have to dig through your PC to find your program. Ideally, to make this easier for you, to guarantee that you find it, if you don't know where it is, make sure you go to the C drive because all of the classic apps are there. For example, I am going to add Adobe Photoshop. To do this, I'm going to go to my C drive, and then I'm going to go to the program files, and then I'm going to click on Adobe, and then I'm going to look for Photoshop. Here it is. And then let me click on the Photoshop program application, the .exe file, and the shortcut is fine as well. So I'm going to choose that and then click add. And there you go, Photoshop is added. And now if I click on it and click options, I will see a list of graphics preferences. System default means your computer can decide which one to use depending on your scenario, your integrated graphics or your dedicated graphics. Power saving, most likely that will be your integrated graphics. High performance, boom, raw power. Most likely it's going to use your dedicated graphics. So if you want, you can choose that and click save. And that's it. This is how you can easily assign a GPU to your app on Windows 10. In a different video, I'm going to show you how you can actually check which GPU your application is using. So you can check if this is working for you or not. Definitely, please subscribe for more, and thanks for watching.